this video, I'm probably going to just mostly be pulling this engine out. I haven't had any takers on it. Like I said, if you guys want or need this engine, it'll go cheap. That or it'll go to scrap, and I'll pull the parts that are worthwhile off, like the starter that I just bought and the coil, and sell them separate. Anyways, we'll get to it. Hey everybody, I'm still collecting parts for this 5.3 I just got. My buddy gave me a 6.0 flywheel for a 4L80 with a spacer. So that'll go right into a turbo 400. And I've got a buddy with a 4-wheel drive turbo 400 that is making me a deal on it. I think those change out. You can just change the output housing. Don't quote me, I'm trying to figure it out. Sorry. This one I think needs a apse sensor. It's a 24 valve Cummins I'm working on currently. But I went to the yard, the salvage yard or scrap yard, and I scored some more parts. There's a water pump with a idler pulley there, and then the bracket for the alternator you see there. If I get that turbo 400, then I'll have enough to mock the motor into this car, and I've got to get a couple jack stands and stuff to get this thing up in the air so I can get my fat ass under it to rip this motor out. But that's the plan. This video, I'm probably gonna just mostly be pulling this engine out. Anyways, we'll get to it. Quick tip for you guys, if you're watching the video this far, if you've got a hood on a car that you're not too concerned about being show quality, you can take a drill bit and drill through your hood hinges into the hood, and then you can take that drill bit and run the bolts in with that drill bit in that hole, and it'll be most generally in the same spot, which is, you know, for something like this that has hood pins, it could be a nightmare to really line up. So just a tip for you guys. Alright, so I gotta say thank you to my buddy Ryan that helped me do this. I needed some help lifting this thing out and removing the hood and everything, and he was Johnny on the spot when I needed some help to get this out. I got slant six in the engine out, or the trans out. Got all this nice space for new activities. For a reference, let me see if I can just set this here. See, there's probably close to 18 inches up here. And I know that's just rough, but on these Chrysler products, it kind of renders a little bit of a challenge when you go to put the LS in, because you have to run a front sump. You can see that the steering linkage and stuff back here is right directly where a truck pan would be. And even if you get like a weird pan, it's not gonna work. So people run like a GTO pan. The bad thing about that is the GTO pan is very expensive. So I don't know yet if I'm gonna go with an aftermarket pan or what I'm gonna do quite yet. But for now, I've got this ripped out and I've got the parts for that 5.3. I'm starting to accumulate. I just need an alternator, which push comes to shove, I have the one off my 6-liter over there that I can throw on it. But yeah, I got this out, and what I plan on doing is when I do a front sump, I'm going to cut this here and here and move this mount. This is probably, I haven't really thought about this, where this is going to go, but I'll have to figure something out on it. I'll end up cutting it here and here, like I said, and then run tube 45 it back, and then up, and then another tube, and then have the cross member support back here, have this all open, and maybe even run one up here where just in front of it. I haven't much given it thought because I don't have the pan that I need to use. But yeah, probably gonna be, I'm really trying to get a turbo 400. It's kind of hard to find it for whatever reason, to find a short shaft turbo 400 with a slip yoke around here. I'm trying to get it cheap is the reason, but yeah. The boat anchor's out of the way. I think I showed you guys I got some parts for getting the front dress on this. And then I've got the intake there, and I've got the 6-liter style 4L80 flywheel or flex plate. That's about it. You can see it's nice and clean in here. I think I showed that last video. So next video, I'm gonna really try hard to either be working on the rear axle, or either that tearing down the 5.3, or having something where I can work on mounting the engine in this, because ideally I would like to throw this in, throw the 5.3 turbo 400 in, see where it sits, see what I need to do for the mounts and stuff, and then you know, fab up something that would be, you know, a mark where the trans mount is going to be and where this is going to be, and then I can modify this cross member. I got to put my bender and stuff in, but I'll be able to, you know, modify that and make it work. As always, I appreciate you guys watching my videos. I got a lot of new subscribers from, I think, Matt's shout out on Sloppy Mechanics. I appreciate that. Hopefully you guys stay watching the channel. It won't be real long. I'll have I'll hopefully have this engine set in here, and my goal is maybe January-ish, I'll have it running as a naturally aspirated setup. So, like I said, thanks again for watching. I'll see you guys on the next one. Until then, take it easy.